That's it. That's, wow. Why didn't I open with that? God damn. Coffee drinkers, bass players of the world, today marks a pretty significant turning point in my musical career, in my journey as a recording artist. And over the years, over the last decade or so of being engaged and involved with you, with the audience, with the fans, with the followers, with the people who check out my music, with the conversation that goes on, I feel like I see you as the kind of fan or follower who would like to help me go on this new journey. So I'm here to ask you, will you come with me? Because there's pretty much no way I can do it on my own. It's a pretty scary place to get to. I'm going to get to the details of that in just a second. But it's also at the same time incredibly exciting. And let's wind it back. Let's go back a month from here, where I kind of unplugged myself from social media a little bit and stopped following other people on all platforms. And that kind of like quietened down the noise a little bit in my periphery. It gave me some breathing space to think about, like, what am I doing? What's next? We're kind of coming out of the pandemic here. What's the story I have to tell? And what's the story I want to tell? And how do I want to communicate that? Pretty quickly, it was, you know, the alarm bells ringing, like, well, it's been 3 years since I made a new record. I've been talking about doing this record for months now, but I really sort of like kicked it into overdrive and decided, okay, this is it, the new trio. We're going to go to Spain to this beautiful studio. We're going to record for a few days. We're going to have a film crew come and document the entire process. It's going to be one of the bigger, more challenging, but hopefully higher value productions, higher value projects I've ever produced as an artist. So you might be asking yourself, what is this journey? But how can you be involved? Like, what on earth am I talking about here? Well, first of all, it's really important. I have to be very upfront and transparent about this. It's really important for me to explain in no uncertain terms that by launching this pre-sale for the new album today, this is not Kickstarter. This is not GoFundMe. This is not crowdsourcing in order to finance a project. The project is going to happen just anyway. If I do one sale or 1,000 sales right now over the next, you know, couple of weeks, months before the album comes out, the album is still going to happen regardless. What I'm asking for you guys to do is to come and kind of join me on the inside of this journey. You'll see when you go to the website, the links are below. There are kind of 5 different levels of engagement, of involvement, for hopefully for everyone's budget. I don't want to lock anyone out here. And the whole why of this is because I want to get away from what has become our new normal of releasing music, of recording music and then releasing it, and it ends up on Spotify, Apple Music, just insert name of streaming service here. And it's taken all the scarcity and the kind of that special element of the album launch, of the release of the music, of the anticipation. It's really kind of muted that a lot for me. You know, like I said, I kind of disengaged from social media a little bit from a follower standpoint, just to see, you know, where everything sat for me. And that was kind of one of the conclusions I came to, was just overwhelmed because there was so much information out there. And I started unsubscribing from email lists, and just it was so much nicer to get that one email from the little boutique pedal company that they were restocking a pedal. And I was like, wow, I'm going to be one of the few people, if I get up at the right time and in a European time, and I hit the button and I get it in my car and I buy it, I can be one of the few people who gets that kind of really special thing. So through doing that, through being a fan of other people's work, especially pedals right now, looking for new, weird and wonderful sounds for my own music, it really made me think, oh, I want to do that for my audience. I want to change what we accept now as normal. So here's what I'm doing. The new album, I'm like, just, it's every day. It's all day, every day. It's on my mind, creating playlists of music that's inspiring me, new combinations of pedals, talking to the guys in the band, the engineer, the film crew. Just really, it's, I'm excited, as you could probably tell, I'm super excited to be back in that space of making music. So that's the kind of the basic catalyst of what. Of course, there's going to be an album. Now, I've set a release date of May 15th. I've always done that. I've always set a release date before I've even recorded a note of music. It really keeps me motivated, gives me this goal to head to. It's a common, you know, if you get involved in the pre-sale, for instance, we all know that that's the day the music's coming out. It's just a nice anticipatory, is that a word? I'm sure that's a word. It's a nice, it's some nice anticipation leaning up towards this date where you, you know, if you're digging what you hear, you're going to get a large dose of that on that day. So that's what's happening initially. Now, with the pre-sale, even on the most basic package, you'll get the whole album in one go. We're also with a beautiful digital booklet. You know, I wish I had a CD to hand right now, because I miss that packaging, or even a piece of vinyl where you had that big piece of art and then information about the music and the musicians and where it was recorded and dates and places, and you could kind of build this bigger fantasy picture of imagining the studio. Maybe there was a one photograph of the studio and you're like, whoa, that's what it was like to be there. So that's what I want to build into this digital product. So we're going to do a really amazing digital booklet with tons of photographs. We've got a photographer coming to do stills. Chelsea, I'm sure, is going to do an unbelievable job in kind of capturing the essence of what the sessions were. In this digital booklet, I also found some cassette tapes, some bootleg cassette tapes of my band, my main band as a band leader from the late 90s before I moved to America, that actually features Tom Corley, my piano player, who's recording on this album. So I've been kind of digitizing those, and they're a little scratchy. They're definitely on the bootleggy side, but I've been digitizing those, and we're going to give those as a little bonus. Some of me and Tom playing 25 years ago, that would be some kind of bonus tracks for certain levels of the pre-sale. And then, of course, high quality. I want to give you guys high quality audio. I don't want it to be this kind of really average MP3 sound. So we're going to do FLAC files. I guess kind of like Bandcamp allows you to download high resolution files. We're going to do that. That'll be included in the package. And then I'm going to do one of the tiers of the package is going to be my entire discography. So if you're into that kind of higher tier of it, you'll get the entire 12 or 13 albums, whatever it is now. And then, of course, kind of the part of the project I think that I'm most excited about, because it's a documentary film. There's a film crew coming. We're going to make this movie, and you're going to get to see how it all happens from the very first notes to the completion of the project and everything, all the layers that happen in there. So that's something I tried to do, like I said recently, with It Only Happens Once, that didn't really come to fruition. This time, I've really thought it out, spent a lot of time, hired the right people, and I'm really looking forward to being able to present that. There are a couple of extra kind of higher end tiers for the pre-sale if you're so inclined. We're going to do a Zoom call. That's limited to 10 people, unfortunately, because it can't just be like crazy and cluttered. We're going to do a Zoom call right after the release of the album. It'll just be for 10 people, and it'll be with the whole band and crew. So they're all over the world, Argentina, Denmark, UK, France, just all over the place. So we're going to get them all together on Zoom, and 10 people, 10 of you will get to ask questions and, you know, talk to the guys in the band. And hopefully you will have heard the music by then. You'll have seen the movie, and you hopefully will have some questions about how we did things, and yeah, nerdy pedal things or recording things. How did we record bass? Where did the ideas for certain songs come? That kind of thing. So we're going to do that. And then the very highest tier, I know it's not for everyone, and there are only three of them. There are only three personal songs, but we're going to release three one-of-one songs that only you, the buyer, will ever have. I'm never going to release them commercially. It'll be something that you own. You choose to do whatever you want with it, share it with people, play it to people, keep it for yourself. But those will be kind of, they're not going to be cheap, to be very upfront about that. But they are going to be unique, and there'll be three songs that three people in the world get to buy that will never be public. Kind of like the Wu-Tang Clan thing where they did their album, they only made one copy, and I think they sold it for $1 million or something crazy. In that kind of vein. And of course, for everyone involved in the pre-sale, I'll be putting you guys on a kind of a little private mailing list and giving you little updates and little snippets and behind the scenes stuff as we go through the process. Because here we are, middle of March, we're recording in 2 weeks from now, and then the album will be coming out in the middle of May. So there are a lot of steps in the process still to go, and that's what I want to share with the people who get involved in the journey at this point with the pre-sale and kind of come along for the ride. So that's it. It's kind of a pitch, but it's also just letting you know what's going on. Like I said, I'm not doing this to fund the album. The album is going to happen regardless of how many pre-sales I end up selling. It's not crowdsourcing. I really believe there is value in what I do and in my art. And if it ends up only being for me, that's still really, really valuable to me. And although that will cost a lot of money, will put me significantly in the hole if I don't sell some records, I still want to be very clear that that is of immense value to me as an artist. And I think that honesty is super important, like right from the get-go. I've always tried to do that, and now I want to kind of step that up and take it to the next level and kind of show you every single step of the way. And for those people interested post pre-sale, when all this thing is over that I'm talking about right now, the idea is to release to the public, people who didn't buy the pre-sale, 2 singles a month. So there'll be singles going out there. They'll only be available at my website for download. So that's how the general public is going to get it if they're not a part of the pre-sale. It'll be 2 singles a month for 5 months or so, kind of leading into the European tour coming at the end of the summer, beginning of the fall. And hopefully, fingers crossed, I can do a bit of a screening of the movie, of the documentary, on 1 or 2 of the tour stops in Europe. That would be fantastic. My dream would be to do it in London, my hometown, do a huge show, really give a proper album launch and screen the movie at the same time. Really important note, and you'll see it in the product descriptions on the website, link below for the pre-sale. Really important to note that this is not something that's just going to get uploaded to YouTube. I'm not making this movie for YouTube or Instagram or Facebook or anything like this. This is a movie. It's a proper release. It's for sale. It's for download. I think we're going to do it through Vimeo. Don't hold me to that. That's the plan right now, but it will be for sale. I'm not going to water down the value of that by just throwing it out there in the world. That is what I want to get away from. That's what I want to get away from Spotify, away from long form stuff being put out there for free, and hopefully bringing some of you guys along for this journey and showing you, I don't know, it sounds kind of soppy and cheesy, but showing you the deep joy that it brings me to do what I do. I don't think I can put it any better than that. I should probably end the video with that, because that is exactly, that's it. That's exactly how I want to put it. That's what I want to share. Wow. Why didn't I open with that? God damn it. So before I start getting into thinking about all that stuff and pedals and all the unbelievably great people that are going to be around me, I'll leave it at that. The links are below. There are 5 tiers. I hope I've made them accessible to everyone. I really hope you enjoy the music. I hope you enjoy the journey. I hope there's a bigger picture there than just the music. The music is just kind of one part of this kind of much bigger picture for me. And there is really a lot more to come. This is a huge turning point for me and something I'm really, really, really happy and excited to share with you guys. So that's it. I'm sure I'll talk more to you. There'll be more videos. We're going to do some promo. Of course, after the sessions are done, I'll have some cool footage to share with you guys, and promos will start popping up. But yeah, links are below. Pre-sale, 5 tiers. Let me know. Let me know what you think. I don't know. Maybe I'm party of one here, and I'm totally out of my mind. I'd love to hear your feedback on that. That doesn't matter, good or bad. Let me have it. But that's it. I love you guys. Coffee drinkers. Start of a big journey. I hope a few of you are going to come with me and check out what's to come.